20 years ago, I was doing a workshop in Los Angeles, and I've used a wireless mic for a long time, and I was there, and everybody was busy. It was a belief system workshop, so everybody was doing some journaling, and I thought, you know, this is a really good opportunity for me to run to the restroom while they're busy doing their stuff. And I work with these masters known as the Hathors. And they're all about the energy really flowing and just they're known as masters of sound and love. And so anyhow, I'm always very careful when I go to the restroom when I have a wireless mic on, because that time I went while everybody was busy doing their writing, and I came back to the door and I thought, oh, I better turn my mic back on. And I reached down and it was already on. And so everybody went to the restroom with me. And so it was an interesting experience. It definitely lightened the energy, the vibration in the room, you know, because it was getting kind of heavy, you know, with all the journaling and stuff. And that's one of the things about the Hathors, you know, it's like if things get too heavy, they want to do something to help raise, you know, and keep things flowing, because if they get stuck, they stop and nothing flows. So at my expense, they decided to assist. So anyhow, I'm always really careful when I have a wireless mic on now to be sure that it's off when I go to the restroom. So anyhow, I want to welcome everyone here this evening. Sorry for the delay. This is a regular meditation experience that I do, which I call Monday Night Live. It's a holographic sound healing meditation experience. So, and I do it once a month, either on the first or second Monday of the month, depending on my travel schedule. So next month it'll be on the first Monday, whereas this one, I just got back from Egypt. This is my excuse for all this stuff. I just got back from Egypt Saturday night, so I'm still recovering. So that's my excuse for any goofos tonight, okay? Mm-hmm. So we good on that? I've been taking groups to Egypt for 23 years now, and it's an absolute amazing experience every time, you know, and this was no exception. And I've actually got another one planned for December of this year. We'll be leaving on the 4th of December. I have some flyers out in front for those of you that might be interested. And if not this year, maybe next year. So we have a sign-up sheet. And for those of you that are online, that are streaming with us, you can just fill in the information, the form from the website and all of that, and we'll get you the information about Egypt or any of the other trainings that are coming up. I teach a certification training in sound, which is called holographic sound healing. And so all that information is on the website. I don't want to really take too much time going into that. Tonight, we've just moved through a full moon. And I'm sure everyone, who was it that said Mercury was retrograde right now? Isn't that just great? sometimes we can breeze through it, and sometimes we get little, you know, weird stuff. There's another S word I was going to use, but I thought stuff would be better. So anyhow, so that there's that, that's going on. But we just went through a full moon, a beautiful full moon, and it's the full moon in the sun sign of Taurus. And that and the days around that are known as Buddha's birthday celebration. and which is also referred to as WESAC. And WESAC, the reason for WESAC is if the big party goes on in the WESAC Valley in Tibet. And the party is all about the masters coming together and celebrating Buddha's birthday. And so I thought it would be appropriate that we celebrate Buddha's birthday and that we go to the WESAC Valley and experience our meditation along with the masters. Does that sound okay? So this brass bowl up here, if you, there should be a piece of paper somewhere around where you're sitting. And if you want to put an intention into the bowl, please do so. Just write it down real quick and put it in. And if not, then just set an intention for yourself. Hold it in your consciousness. And the sounds, the vibrations that come through will help to energize and fulfill those intentions that you set for yourself. And the thing about setting intentions is it's not about, I want to get rid of this and I want to get rid of that. It's about, and of course we do want to get rid of this and get rid of that and transform and transcend and all of that. But the intention is seeing that already done. Whatever it is that you would be able to benefit from that change, that transformation, that's your intention. So write it down as the completed experience. Not that it's going to happen, not that it's, you know, today, tomorrow, whatever, but it's happening right now. Right now, it's a done deal. So that's your intention. So, and it could be something physical, could be something emotional, could simply be that you just want to have a good time and a good experience, whatever it might be. So either hold that intention in consciousness and just for a bit until we take you into La La Land, or also you can put it in the bowl. Okay? Questions? Just begin to focus on your breathing. I invite you to close your eyes. If you choose, and focus on the inhale and the exhale of your breath. Around our group. spray of the water. And once you have reached it, the water showering over your being, over your body, as it cleanses, clears, and heals. As you remember your intentions for a moment, and now just let them go, for the universe has heard your request. The universe has seen and heard your intentions. And as you stand before the waterfall, you see there is a tunnel behind it, a cave. Without thought, moving into the cave, moving through it, for it isn't long, and it takes you into a beautiful valley. And as you step into this valley, the colors vivid all around you. Greens, blues, reds, yellows like you've never seen before. Beautiful. For this is the Wisak. Come to celebrate with the masters, to celebrate the Buddha's birthday. And as you move into the valley, the masters have joined you, the angels, the archangels, all around you, for they see you as the master that you are. No different. Master to master. And as you move deeper into the valley, connect with the various masters that approach you or that you approach, for they're all here. Speak with them, share with them, master to master. Questions you may have, you may ask. And as you do so, allow yourself to journey as you breathe, wherever you are, know that your crown is wide open as the brilliant light of the divine fills, penetrates throughout your being, throughout your body, every cell illuminated, every chakra illuminated, in harmony, in joy, in goodness, in good health. And as your crown is wide, allow yourself thank you.
Essence.
close this moment, I invite each of you to join with me and let us complete together with three alms. Take in a deep breath. Just a few moments in silence. As you're feeling ready, just open your eyes. I'd like to take just a moment, and if there's anything that anyone would like to share of your experience or any questions and comments, please feel free to do so. But not all at once.
I was like really deep in the valley.
You, sorry?
I said I was like really deep in the valley.
Yeah.
I saw the colors a lot.
A lot of colors.
Cool. Thank you.
I'm pregnant and my baby was kicking around.
Oh, yeah. Having a good time.
Yeah, she was loving it.
Dancing.
Yeah.
When the drums.
Sorry? What was. The Hathors, these beings that I work with, They're very connected with dolphins and whales. And so they'll come through from time to time. Thanks. Anybody else? So we do the evening on a blood donation basis. And those of you online that have joined us, there should be a link for you if you haven't already done all that. And for those of us here that haven't already, there's a basket at the
front.
What?
At the entrance.
At the entrance. Okay. This is Aisha. Aisha is my assistant. She takes care of everything. So couldn't do it without her. So there's a basket up at the front on the table, right? Okay. And you can just, and those of you online that don't have a table with a basket on it, or you might, but don't drop it there, and I'll do the link. And for those of you that are following us online, it's time for us to say goodbye. I want to thank you for your presence, for the vibration that you bring to this experience. Much love, and hope to see you next month. It'll be on the first Monday of the month, the 5th, I believe, of June. Thank you. Blessings.